The scheme will be funded entirely out of borrowed money of rupees 75,000 crore. While I welcome the support of farmers, I ask, what about the non-farmer poor? What about the urban poor? The new scheme is intended to help the farmer, but in reality, it will also help the absentee landlord. I would like to ask how the government will reach the money to the tenant farmer and farm laborer who actually tills the land. I have no doubt in my mind that the Congress's announcement of a minimum income guarantee will bring true relief to all the poor households and families of the country, both farmer and non-farmer, and both rural and urban. The overall impression one got from listening to the budget speech was that the government believed its own fake statistics. Every report from the field, from academics, NGOs, journalists, has exposed the false claims made in respect of ODF-free villages, domestic electricity connections, use of LPG cylinders, and mudra loans. None of the numbers put out by the government is true, but the government is so blinded by the dazzle of its fake numbers that it is not able to see that thousands of toilets that were constructed are unused or unusable, that there are thousands of villages and millions of homes that do not get electricity, while the homemaker has taken the first free cylinder and the stove, she does not take the second or subsequent cylinder because she cannot put together a lump sum of rupees 750 to 900 on the day she needs the money, and the mudra loans have only added to the accumulation of NPAs. No one believes this government's claims anymore, and I too shall dismiss the tall claims as irrelevant. The direct tax concessions were beyond the authority of the government that will lay down office in 100 days. They seem to have been added at the last hour after the budget numbers were finalized. We will study them carefully in order to find out if they are in accord with the projections of revenue from income tax. In conclusion, I have to point out that while I'm a strong supporter of the use of Hindi and English as official languages, no one intended that the two languages should be used alternately or simultaneously. Those who knew only Hindi did not understand one half of the budget speech, and those who knew only English did not understand the other half. Perhaps that was the real intention of the government, leave the people confused at least for a day. The mist that wraps this budget will lift by tomorrow, and the people will see the desperation and recklessness of the government.